Building a full-size paper boat in a small room isn't comfortable but possible. To say I have no space to create would be a perfect excuse. Small-minded twats wouldn't take this challenge in fear of defeat, destroying the house or getting beaten up by their girlfriends. I've come across some artists saying that if you don't have space to create, then don't do it because epoxy at home isn't healthy. Well, life is too short and some people aren't even worth feeding. Luckily, the only thing I'm depending on is a very small budget, so whenever that budget isn't cutting my wings, I build whatever I can. I think the biggest disadvantage during the process is the epoxy dripping everywhere and not being able to turn the 5 meter boat around freely. It's possible to fit it in the room, but hard to maneuver. What makes things even harder is the fact that it's a practice project, which I'm doing to gain knowledge so my erratic mind fit not only one boat in the studio flat, but four of them at the same time. Here we have the body of T1, which you are watching now. There is also a second boat, T2, and T3, which is almost ready to launch, and fourth, possible Atlantic Tryton. Before I cover the next boat, I wanted to show you the first one, because it's a very sentimental for me and I truly love this boat. It's the most beautiful thing I ever made. My name is Mr. Eternal and this is my shipyard in my studio flat. After 6 months break in the project, when more certain times have come, I come back to building T1. I laid out all the elements and I don't know if they didn't fit or I forgot the order of the steps, but they weren't perfect, so I bent them, stretched them and added cardboard pipes to strengthen the skeleton, and it comes out beautiful. In the means of weight, it's not so bad. Well, I don't know about the weight of boats, but I guess if I can lift the whole thing, then it's fine. I started reinforcing the bottom with 2 mm cardboard and I thought, why did I try to make two boats with such weak materials when this is almost perfect? By almost, I mean it's still paper that dissolves in water. I've added a few more layers wasting loads of epoxy, but I created a very strong bottom of the boat. Seriously, like the bulletproof windows of Cybertruck. This experience will help me build better, more durable boats. T3 will be mainly made of cardboard blocks stuck together with epoxy resin. Let's stay with the first boat. When I'm looking at it today, I'm terrified about the amount of pins I've put in it. My fingers were bleeding, but I didn't see any other option. I coated the fragment with epoxy once, waited for it to soak in, then coated it again and again, and then pinned it to the boat. When I was making bigger pieces that didn't require so much epoxy, I used tape to hold it together and waited for the epoxy to set. My knees, fingers and wrists still hurt a bit to this day, but back then it was pure pain. You need to admit that for an amateur working in a studio flat, it comes out pretty nice. I've gained a lot of experience building it, so I'm rather happy. I thought I'm a heartless bastard, but my heart was bleeding when I decided to stop making this boat and destroy it. Okay, it's a lie. I'm pragmatic at time, so I destroyed this beauty that wouldn't be of much use anymore and was just taking out the precious space. Tryton T1, what you see here, doesn't exist anymore. Once again, I'm telling you, I'm doing this to gain essential experience, because the goal I set for myself is to build a boat and sail around the world in it, so I try to gain the experience in every way I can. What awaits me this year? Launching the boat and sailing the 100 kilometers I promised. But that's not all. The boat I will show to the world will be exploited to the maximum. I don't care if it strains the constructions. All that counts is getting the experience in sailing and proving that a paper boat can swim and I can build boats. A fully paper boat, without any fiberglass or any artificial fibers like some posers use in pressing on our folks. You may disagree with me, but covering paper boat with the laminate and saying it's a paper is just cheating. I won't make this monologue any longer. I will just say there will be about 3 more short films like this, and I will focus on the final project, which is a full-size paper boat that is in a very advanced stage, so there is a lot to look forward to. I'm trying to catch up with the content for YouTube. Stay with me, support me, and I will take you on an interesting journey. Until next time.